back your chest, all your vital organs. Keep moving down to your hips, your pelvis, glutes, hamstrings, quads, knees, calves, ankles.
Hello. And wait, toes. I'm ready. Go ahead.
Whenever sounds come up, whenever you have that temptation to be distracted, just acknowledge it and come back to your breath. Go ahead and start engaging a more controlled breath. In yoga, we call it ujjayi, but you're just closing your throat a little bit, kind of like you're warming up your hands on a cold day, that kind of breath. Just do that same kind of breath through your nose. You might sound like Darth Vader, that's okay. Breathe nice and slow in and out. Five breaths at your own pace, right, dude? Gauge your breath, settle down your nervous system. Get ready to move and flow and stretch and expand. Three more breaths. From the seated position, we're going to bring our hands together right in our lap. We're going to be doing circle breaths. You plug your eyes open, watch me here. So we're going to be inhaling all the way up above our head and circling our arms down as we exhale. We're going to go up and down just like this. It's called a washing machine breath. We're inhaling up, exhaling down, and try to alternate which hand goes first on the way down each time. So you're getting equal stretches on both your arms. Inhaling up, exhaling down. Keep that going. We have 8 more of these. Tailbone rises towards the sky, engaging our calves and our hamstrings. For this first one, we can just pedal out our feet. So straighten your left leg, bend your right knee, and switch sides. Straighten your right leg, bend your left knee. Stretching one leg and then the other. You can also feel this in your sciatica, your lower back. Making sure we're keeping that consistent breath. If you catch yourself holding your breath, that's okay, but we'll come back to that deep ujjayi breath. Three more big breaths here. Last one. Good. So now we're going to go through a plank vinyasa flow. So we're going to inhale, we're in high plank. We're going to exhale down the low plank. Inhale to upward facing dog. We're going to exhale to downward facing dog. We're going to do this 5 times. So if you're ready for my count, I'll lead you through each step. Let's inhale to high plank. Exhale to low plank. Nice and slow. See how far you can go. Inhale to up dog. Exhale to down dog. That's one. Inhale high plank. Exhale low plank. up dog. And last one, inhale high plank, exhale low plank, soul point of the day. Inhale up dog, exhale down dog. And from here, go ahead and tiptoe your way, take your time all the way to the front of your mat, and stay in this forward fold position. Feet are about hips distance apart. You can bend your knees a little bit, let your chest rest on your thighs. And lock arms to opposite elbows. Hang nice and heavy, stretch out your upper back, and let your head hang heavy too. Gently rock from side to side, stretching your lower back, so elbows come to the outside of our knees. We'll do this 5 times at your own pace. One more each side. Now head hangs heavy again, nod your head yes, release any tension in your neck, shake your head no, and do little circles, gentle circles, clockwise and counterclockwise with your head. Now one vertebrae at a time with your head, the last thing to come up to a standing position, let your arms hang heavy. Down. This time forward fold with our legs straight. See how much we can expand our hamstrings.
I think so too, yeah.
Yeah. Your gaze comes between your knees or up towards your navel. Really lengthen your tailbone. After one more breath here, inhale to flat back.
So we're at a 90 degree angle with our back and our legs.
And we're going to exhale back to that same vinyasa flow. So we're back in high plank. We're going to exhale to low plank. Inhale to up dog. Exhale to down dog. And we have 3 more of those. Inhale to high plank. Exhale low plank. Inhale up dog. Exhale down dog. 2 more. Inhale high plank. Exhale low plank. Inhale up dog. Exhale down dog. And last one. Inhale high plank, exhale low plank, inhale up dog, exhale down dog. Also open up these hips a little bit. We're gonna raise our right leg into three-legged dog. So it should be in a straight line with your spine. From here, we'll spend 2 more breaths here. And on your last breath, you're gonna open up your hips so that they're stacked on top of each other. And you're gonna look under your left armpit to say hi to your right foot. Use your right foot, just rotate your ankle, kind of like you're waving at yourself. And feel that expansion in your right hip. We're here for 3 more breaths. If it's in your practice, you can flip your dog here. Here's what that looks like. One more big breath here. Step all the way through, knee to nose, back up to three-legged dog, knee to nose, three-legged dog, knee to nose.
toes. Three-legged dog. Need a nose. Three-legged dog. Last one. Need a nose. And step all the way through. This time we're in high lunge. So inhale up. Keep your balance. So on the ball of your back foot, back leg is engaged. Right knee is over your right ankle. You're going to be feeling this front hip. You should feel engagement in your quad where the burn comes in for me. Shoulders relax down away from your ears. We're here for two more breaths. Good. On your last exhale, take your left hand, put it beside your right foot, and twist. So right hand goes towards the sky, or revolve high lunge. We're here for three more breaths. Nice, deep, and slow. Two more breaths. And last one. Good. From here, right hand replaces your left hand. Back foot revolves down, so it's perpendicular to your front foot. And we're coming into side angle pose. So other hand goes up nice and high. We're engaged to our back quad. So in your practice, you can go for this bind. So you can take your right hand underneath your leg. Left hand comes behind your back, finds your hand. And look up towards the sky. One way to work your way to this. Other way, David. There you go. Look around your lower back. There it is. Great stuff. Good. Sarah's got it. Hey, if it's not in your practice, it's not a big deal. No worries. We're here for one more big breath. Good. Hands frame our front foot. Right foot comes back to that high three-legged dog. And we're going to replace it right back on the ground. And our left leg comes up. So we're doing the same thing on the other side now. We're here for two breaths first in this three-legged dog. I feel this stretch in my right calf. There's that much more weight on it. I can get that much deeper. One more breath. Good. Now we're going to stack our hips and open up our left hip. Looking under our right armpit to see our toes. You can rotate your left ankle, little circles, release any tension in it. Here for two more breaths. Option to flip your dog. Last big breath. Good job, Sam. And now we have five steps. Oh, I see you. I see you, Obi.
It's a natural movement.
Yep. Bring that animal flow in. All right, we have five breaths. Bring knee to nose right underneath our body. So left knee to nose. And exhale. Inhale back to three-legged dog. Four more. Exhale. Knee to nose. Inhale three-legged dog. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, three-legged dog. Last one coming up, getting ready to go to high lunge. Knee to nose. Step all the way through. Hamstring our front foot. We're going to get set here. Back leg is engaged. We're on the ball of our foot. Knee over ankle. Inhale to rise. We're in high lunge for five reps. Think a little bit lower your ankle to stretch more in your right hip. That quad engaged. Your shoulders relax away from your ears. Trying to breathe nice and easy, just like when you were sitting down at the beginning of this stretch. Same breath. One more big slow breath in. And as we exhale, moving into revolve high lunge. So right arm comes down, left hand flows towards the sky. We're looking up, checking out those clouds. Maybe trying to count the leaves on the tree. We're not forgetting our breath. Three more here. Good. On your last exhale, left hand replaces right hand. The right hand stretches up towards the sky for side angle pose. Remember, right foot is rotating down, so our heels on the mat now. And if it's in your practice, you go for the bind on this side too. So left hand goes under, comes up towards our hip. Right arm comes behind our back. Good job, Andy. Back leg is engaged. We have that tension there. Working hard in this pose for two more breaths. One more breath in. And on our exhale, frame your front foot. Take a big sigh out. And inhale your back leg back up to three-legged dog behind you. Exhale your feet down. We're back to downward facing dog. We have one more of those vinyasa flows. That's been our heartbeat for this practice. So inhale to high plank. Exhale to low plank. Inhale to up dog. Exhale down dog. Good. Now we're going to tiptoe our way to the front of the mat. Instead of standing up this time, we're going to find a seat. Good. So from here on out, we're in restore mode. Nice and chill. We're going to do a little bit of stretching, a little bit of breathing, and we'll be done. First thing I want you to do, legs are nice and straight, we're finding dandasana. We're on a 90 degree angle, sitting up nice and tall. Spine should be perpendicular to our leg bones. Hands are on either side of our hips. We're going to take five breaths in here, expanding our chest and contracting our chest. So think about it like cat-cow, but we're sitting instead of in tabletop position. So inhale. And exhale, curl. Inhale, expand. Exhale, curl. Inhale, expand. Exhale, curl. Last one. And on this exhale, reach for your shins, your ankles, your toes, or all the way around your feet. Keep your quads engaged and keep your toes pointed back towards your nose. So real quick, we'll play with this. Just stretch the toes, stretch it, see how far down you can get. And then flex your feet and feel that engagement that happens in the back of your hamstrings and your knees. Just play with that. Flex your toes forward and back. Feel the difference between those two in your body. Give yourself a little foot massage while you're down here. You carry us around all day. They do a lot of work. Usually goes unnoticed. Good. Inhale nice and high, hands above our head. And exhale even deeper for another hand for this breath. Here. Let's inhale to rise back up to our seated position. Okay, from here, we'll scoot forward on our mat a little bit and lay down on our back. We're going to bring both knees into our chest, give them a hug, and roll around a little bit. We're going to be doing spinal twists, so release any tension in your back. You can roll side to side, roll forward, back. Maybe your spine's going to pop, that's okay. Maybe you feel some areas of tension in your lats or your lower back. Breathe into those. Good, one more breath. And our transition is gonna be our left leg is gonna go straight, our right leg stays in. What we're gonna do is we're gonna grab our right ankle with our left hand. If you look at me, we're grabbing right here on the outside. We're gonna use our right hand to pull our knee down towards our armpit. So we're opening up our hip, pulling our ankle towards our navel, and pulling our knee towards the outside of our right hip. Good stuff. We're here for three more breaths. Last breath. Now we're flipping which side our knee's on. So our knee is going to come outside of our left hip now. Our right shoulder is going to stay glued to our mat. We're getting the spinal twist in. Our eyes can float over our right shoulder. And our left hand can push our right knee down towards the mat. breaths here. Good. Inhale your knee back to your chest. Give it one more hug before you send it out and switch it with your left. So left knee comes in, give it a hug. We're doing the same thing on the other side. So our right hand's gonna grab our left ankle, pull it in towards our navel. Left hand's gonna grab our left knee, pull it down towards our armpit. We're breathing in this hip opener. Five breaths. Last exhale, left knee comes outside of our right hip, left shoulder stays on the mat, and our gaze comes out over our left shoulder for a spinal twist. One more deep breath all the way in. And as you exhale, bring your knee back to your chest, give it one more hug. Send it back out to meet your right. So two options here. Pigeons in your practice, you can go ahead and start transitioning into pigeon. The other option is to cross your right ankle over your left knee. Raise it up, grab the back of your left hamstring, and pull in the outside of your right hip opener. This is option number one. If you want to try pigeon, the same thing, but you're using the ground instead of your arm to open up your hip. So alignment checks here. Your back leg wants to be straight out from your back, so you don't want to be out here. You want to be directly in line. You want to bring your chest out and then down. Okay, so you're not curling over. Bring out and down as you can. Up, your elbows, bring something to that mouth space kind of version. If you want to challenge yourself a little bit more, you can twist over the same side. So your left hand is spread under your right armpit. With each exhale, try to melt a little bit deeper into your mat. So every time you exhale, try to sink in, get a little bit more comfortable in this uncomfortable position. Five more breaths. Last big breath. On the exhale, you can start unwinding out of your pigeon position. However you want to transition is fine. Some go through down dog. I like to just sit, switch. We're doing the same thing on the left side. Once you get set, go through 10 breaths at your own pace. And it's okay if you aren't in the same variation you were on the right side. Sometimes our left sides are more flexible, less flexible. Whatever's right for you, listen to your body, give yourself that. About 8 more breaths. Five more. Real quick, everyone, peek your head up, wave to Rob. Bye, Rob!
Bye, guys.
Bye, Rob!
Wait, when was he here?
He just came by to say hi. He had work, and then he's going to coach the next week. So he just went by. Three more breaths here. Sorry to disrupt the peace. Last big breath in. On the exhale, start to unwind. Come back up. Put your back leg in front of you. Coming to happy baby. We're just folding over ourselves. We're doing a back bend first. So, on our backs, two options here. You can either come up in the bridge pose, I'll demonstrate. So, hips are coming up high. Hands are locking underneath our tailbone. We're using the tension between our hands to pull our shoulder blades underneath this. We can rise even higher. So, this is option number one. This is bridge. Option number two is wheel. So, wheel, hands come on either side of our ears. We're rising the same way, but our arms are going to be bearing more of the weight than our shoulders. So we're coming up, we're looking down in between our hands, hips rise. We're going to be doing two more back bends. So if you start in bridge and want to try wheel later, that's cool. If you start in wheel and want to chill out as we get into our second and third set, go to bridge, that's cool too. One more big breath here for the first set. And on your exhale, come down nice and slow. Take three transition breaths. And prepare for your second set. So come into your second back bend. We're here for five breaths. Last exhale, come down nice and slow. Three transition breaths. And last back bend of the day. Come up, we're doing seven breaths this time. Challenging ourselves, and then we can sink into relaxation and go on with the rest of our day. Five breaths to go. Final three.
Oh, one. Oh, okay, one.
And last exhale, coming down. Now we're coming into happy baby. Curl your knees towards your chest. Grab the outside of your feet. Gently rock back and forth, left and right. There's any back tension from your shoulders, upper back, spine, lower back. Give yourself a little back massage. You can roll all the way on the left side, roll all the way on the right side. We're here for five more breaths. Give yourself whatever you need. Last two breaths. Nice and slow. Slow as you can. Bring your legs all the way down to Savasana. As we move into corpse pose, I want you to bring awareness to your full body again. Wherever there's tension, release it. You can spread your arms out wide on either side of your hips. Spread your toes out. Wiggle your toes, rotate your ankles and your wrists, and then let them sink into the mat, sink into the grass. Flutter your eyes closed, release any control of your breath, and just breathe. I'm going to lay here for about 2 minutes. I'll watch the time. Just relax, recover, recharge. Coming up on noon, so we're halfway through our day. We'll make the most out of the second half of beautiful Saturday in Piedmont Park. Go ahead and just be in. body. Bring awareness to the breeze. Start to wiggle your toes and your fingers. Relax your jaw, move it back and forth. Rotate your ankles and your wrists. Trying to wake yourself up again. From here, you can walk in your feet so that they're close to your glutes. Your knees are up towards the sky. Bring your feet to the outside of either side of your mat. We're just going to windshield wiper here. So left knee is going to come down towards the middle of your mat. Right knee is going to go outside. A nice and slow inhale back up and exhale down to the left side. So do this at your own pace, inhaling up, exhaling down. Just three more times. Whichever side you're on, go ahead and roll over to that side. So stack your shoulders, rest your head under one of your hands. As slow as you'd like, start to prop yourself up. Meet me in a seated position. Lean lotus, have your legs out, whatever it is.
Breath for over 4 minutes. hold at the bottom and get empty lungs. When you have empty lungs, scan your body, start at the top of your head, and move through your entire body, through your head, neck, shoulders, arms, torso, quads, calves, feet, and toes. Notice any differences you feel from when we started our body scan at the beginning of this process. And gratitude for yourself for coming out here today, waking up nice and bright and early. Moving your body, working up a sweat, and giving yourself some yoga. Sway back and forth, moving intuitively, whatever you want to do. Bring your attention to Abish. Abish is going to talk about an event we're doing next weekend. Super cool way to challenge yourself, get together, sweat some. Abish, you want to tell what you're doing?
Yeah. So you guys have probably heard us talk about it earlier. So next weekend, Saturday, we're doing an event called Air Call. So we're going to be air calling from Park Street Market to Park City Park on the reactions were exactly what I want from the game.
Yes.
That's exactly what I expect from the game. I don't expect you to go, oh my god, yes, let's do this. No, so the reason I'm doing this is because, one, the past 2 years I've pushed myself harder than anything I imagined I would do.
Different ways.
Yeah, exactly.
You'll be on the 5 seconds.